Are you afraid of the dark? You probably should be. Unlike us, these animals have fine-tuned their senses over hundreds of millions of years to thrive in the dark. This is the dark world of nocturnal animals.
Mother, don't mind if I leave the lights on just for the night.
Hey, I'm Tasha the Amazon, and you're watching Animalogic Second Nature. Humans are mostly daytime creatures. Our senses are optimized to see well with lots of light, to spot colorful fruits and potential diurnal predators and prey. But there's a whole other world that wakes up when we sleep, and it's only really since the invention of cameras that we've started to understand it.
Take one, take two, take three, take four flash pictures without changing bulbs. In color, of course.
Nocturnal animals perceive the world in such a different way than we do that it's even impossible for us to truly imagine what it would be like to be a bat or another nocturnal creature. Their senses and behaviors have been forged in fire through countless evolutionary battles. So let's go through their adaptations one by one and see how they got there. First off, their eyes. Most nocturnal mammals don't have as many cones or color receptors, but they do have more rods or light receptors in their eyes. This means that even though they can't see as many colors as daytime animals, they don't need as much light as we do to hunt or to spot predators. Their vision is basically black and white at night, and due to their high light sensitivity, they need to make sure only the right amount of light gets into their retina, which is essentially the sensor inside our eyes. Cats, our most beloved nocturnal hunters, have vertical pupils that give them great control over their aperture. During the day, their pupils are just slits, but in low light conditions, they expand to circles, which allow in 135 times more light than when undilated. For comparison's sake, our eyes only let in 10 times more light at night than during the day. So no matter the amount of light available, cat eyes can see crystal clear. Speaking of crystals, most nocturnal animals have a layer of crystals at the back of the eye that reflects light onto the retina, increasing how much they can see in the dark. You might have seen spooky pictures of gators, big cats, rabbits, and even deer with their eyes shining bright at night. This isn't a supernatural, diabolical possession. It's simply the light bouncing off of their eye crystals. For other nocturnal animals, especially those that live in dense forests, vision is not that important because their sight is obstructed by vegetation and other environmental features. So instead, they've evolved amazing hearing and chemoreception to see their world without even looking. Most mammals have better hearing than we do, and none of them are more synonymous with prodigious hearing than bats. Bat ears evolved to hear extremely high-pitched sounds to find insect prey. Insect mating calls are loud and constant. It helps them find each other, but they have the obvious problem that they also attract predators. So insects evolved to communicate in pitches higher than most mammals can hear. Human ears can hear sounds up to 20 kilohertz. Dogs and cats can hear up to 45 and 65 kilohertz respectively. This is why they can hear dog whistles that our ears are not equipped to hear. But several bat species can hear sounds up to 120 kilohertz, thanks to their evolutionary arms race with insects. This adaptation built the basis for echolocation.
The bat carries its remarkable radar around in its head. Radar that guides it safely through the intense darkness of the caves, that keeps it from colliding with obstacles it cannot see, or with the thousands of other bats flying through the same darkness.
Bat ears are so refined that they can hear the echoes of their own calls. The more calls they make, the more they can hear the sound waves bouncing off trees, rocks, the ground, and everything around them. By doing this, they can create a 3D map of their environment without even using their eyes. Over time, this has led to less reliance on sight, which has made their eyes almost futile. Similarly, insects don't use their eyes to search for food. Their world is made of smells, and they navigate it using chemoreception. Insects have antennae full of chemical sensing cells called chemoreceptors. At night, when it's slightly safer from predators, insects go out to look for food and mates. They're much simpler creatures than mammals, so instead of sensing thousands of smells and choosing which one to follow, they specifically seek the scents that can bring them to food and shelter and the pheromones to find a mating partner. They search for specific chemicals, like carbon dioxide, in the case of blood parasites like bedbugs, mosquitoes, and assassin bugs. Rotting fruits and vegetables attract cockroaches, and decomposing flesh is a magnet for flies and some beetles. We have learned to use this against them, as they also naturally avoid certain chemicals like DEET, which we use as bug spray.
But just sensing the world at night is a small part of the equation. Predators have to find almost undetectable prey while remaining unseen themselves.
The barn owl has keen eyes. It can see mice or other prey at great distances. Its highly sensitive ears can hear the movements of a field mouse far away.
Owls are some of the very few nocturnal birds. Most species hunt nocturnal rodents that often hide under the cover of leaves and grass. To find their meal, they use their specialized ears. Their ear openings are asymmetrical, with one sitting a little higher than the other, so they can pinpoint the location of prey in three dimensions. But then they have to sneak up on their squirrely prey without making any noise.
Bird flight can be surprisingly noisy. Go to any park where there's pigeons and you can hear them fly from across the field. While most birds announce their presence, owls glide in ghostly silence. Their feathers are a marvel of nocturnal engineering, developed for the bird to remain unseen.
This is the sound of a hawk flying. This is the sound of a peregrine falcon flying. And this is the sound of an owl flying.
Owl feathers have serrated comb-like edges that break up the air into micro-turbulences. First, the serrated edges of the feathers break up the airflow. Then, as the air travels along the wing to the trailing edge, fringed feathers further reduce the air disturbance. Finally, the soft downy feathers of the underside of the wing and legs absorbs any additional noise.
Thus, the prey has no warning.
But nocturnal adaptations go beyond being quiet. Some creatures, like fireflies, illuminate the night while communicating in a language of light.
Fireflies light up to find mates. It's nice to smell good, but it helps if you're also glowing. The males fly and light up in specific patterns. The females are usually on the ground scanning the sky for a handsome ray of bugshine. If a female sees a light that she likes, she reciprocates the signal, inviting the male to come over and mate with her.
The chemical reaction that produces light happens in their lower abdomen, which is insect talk for butt, making all their lighting officially booty calls.
The lights are thought to have started as a warning to predators to tell them that fireflies taste pretty bad. But over time, these adaptations were then used for communication between fireflies and became a key part of their reproductive strategy.
These nocturnal adaptations are amazing examples of the power of evolution. But fireflies are not the only creatures that have adaptations that started out as traits for nighttime living. You, me, and every other mammal owe a chunk of our biology to our nocturnal ancestors.
This is the empty eye socket within the skull, with its bony walls inside and the rim of the bony orbit in front.
Synapsids, the reptile-like proto-mammals of the Permian, are thought to have been mostly diurnal. But recent studies based on their eye socket shape have shown that some species could see better at night than during the day. By the time we get to the age of the dinosaurs and the first mammals appear, around 200 million years ago, they were all nocturnal. We believe that diurnal reptiles outcompeted them and pushed them into nocturnal niches.
Mammals have a lot of adaptations for nighttime, like great hearing and sense of smell, amazing sense of touch, especially through whiskers. We're hot-blooded, have brown fat tissue and fur to warm us up, and a lack of eye protection against UV light. Even our nails are the remnants of what were once digging claws.
The vast majority of mammals are still small nocturnal animals. Rodents, felines, most canids, small marsupials, raccoons, skunks, and tarsiers, among many others, still prefer to be blanketed by darkness.
Unfortunately, humans are having a worldwide negative impact on nocturnal species. Our artificial lights are causing trouble for animals who might not understand what a light bulb is.
Some animals, like moths, frogs, and sea turtle babies, are attracted to light, which often leads them to human spaces where they're easily caught by predators or have dangerous encounters with people. Light also changes the natural behaviors of raccoons and other species whose circadian rhythms get altered by our streetlights.
Thankfully, there are lots of initiatives to support nocturnal species all over the world. So please support your local animal conservation organizations. You can help us protect these amazing nightcrawlers so that they continue to thrive in the dark. So what should we talk about next? Let me know in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe for new episodes every week. Bye.
What the f was that? He literally
it really
is.
Fell, like, it really fell apart. It's like you tried to clap it while falling down.
Like he could not care less. Oh, he was just like,
whoa!
Okay. Oh my god.